Xbox is doing significantly better in Japan. It looks like we may be seeing Hellblade 2 at the Game Awards, and the KFC Gaming Twitter got into a fight with Back 4 Blood. So it looks like Xbox is doing significantly better this generation in Japan compared to the Xbox One generation, as they have already hit over 100,000 units sold between the Xbox Series X and S compared to the Xbox One, where it took them 4 years to reach this feat. Now, Xbox has done a lot of stuff with the launch of the Xbox Series X and S to really improve their status in Japan. Right from the beginning, we heard Phil Spencer talk about how he wants to be at the top of the mind of Japanese gamers, and that it was unacceptable, the performance of Xbox in Japan with the Xbox One. And there's a lot of things Xbox is doing good here to increase the amount of numbers, to increase the amount of people playing on an Xbox in Japan. A couple of things like getting more JRPGs on to Xbox Game Pass, more games that players in that region will want to play. The actual sizes of the consoles, if you look at the size of the Xbox Series S and the Xbox Series X, you compare it to the PlayStation 5, the form factor of the Xbox is significantly better, especially for people there that live in smaller places, don't have as much space, and will be able to fit these consoles easily within their entertainment system. The Xbox Series S specifically, I mean, it is at cheaper price. It is such a small, nice form factor that a lot of people enjoy having. You can really put it anywhere. You can transport it. And then you think about what they're doing with Xbox Game Pass, just recently launching xCloud in Japan, where people can play on their mobile devices anywhere. And in order to get people signing up for that service, you're gonna have to have the content within Xbox Game Pass. And I think they are on their way, and they're already kind of doing it when you think about like the Square Enix games, you think about the Sega games on there, and many other JRPGs that are on the service itself. So they're doing a lot and reaching that 100,000 units in under 1 year on the market compared to the amount of time it took with the 4 years with the Xbox One, I think is a really awesome job. And overall, the relationship between Xbox and Japan has kind of shifted every single generation. When you think back to the Xbox 360, it did decently over there, and there were games that were only available in Japan. And also here in the West, we got a lot more cooler JRPGs for the Xbox 360. It was non-existent with the Xbox One, and I think we're getting closer to that Xbox 360 era in Japan with the Xbox Series X and S. So we're getting closer and closer to the Game Awards in December. I believe it's on December 9th, the day after Halo Infinite launches. And Xbox has always had a cool presence at the Game Awards. We got the actual announcement of the Xbox Series X at the Game Awards, and then I believe they showed the first Hellblade 2 trailer at the Game Awards. I could be wrong on that, but I believe that's where we saw that really cool trailer with the graphics and just how amazing that it looked. And it seems like they're going to continue along those lines with this year's Game Awards, as it seems more and more likely that Hellblade 2 will be showing off at the 2021 Game Awards. Jez Corden saying this on his most recent podcast, saying, "I teased on my podcast recently that I bet money that we'd see another Xbox exclusive Hellblade 2 at the Game Awards this year. Since I've indeed heard that it was in the plan to show more of the game by the end of the year, perhaps we could get 2-for-1 deal, see Avowed show up there too, but it may be too early just yet." And this is kind of building off of what we saw yesterday with the Avowed stuff and getting more information about the game. But Hellblade 2 is probably more guaranteed to be seen at the Game Awards. I mean, it's not confirmed or anything like that. But in general, I would love to see maybe a couple of games from Xbox showing off at the Game Awards. That would be awesome because it's a big show. It is really more for the reveals and for the trailers than the awards, in my opinion. It almost seems like they put the awards on the back burner as their small segments, and then we get all of the announcements and all that kind of stuff. And for me, that's fine because I don't really care too much about the awards. I'm there to watch the trailers and the reveals. The KFC Gaming decided to take a shot at the recent Day One Xbox Game Pass release Back 4 Blood, and also take a shot at Turtle Rock, who ironically actually developed both of these games, so it's kind of a weird shot to take. But they tweeted this out: "Every masterpiece has its cheap copy, having Left 4 Dead on the left and Back 4 Blood on the right." Now, Back 4 Blood, I haven't played yet. As you guys can see, I'm not at home. I don't have my Xbox with me, so I haven't been able to check out this game yet, but I will be checking it out next week, so I am very excited for it. I did play the beta a while ago and had a lot of fun with it, but it's a game people kind of have been waiting for. People have wanted a new Left 4 Dead game for a very long time, and finally we got the spiritual successor to it with Back 4 Blood. And the greatest thing of all is that it's on Xbox Game Pass on day one. So KFC decided to take this weird shot at it, I guess for publicity's sake, just to get out there, get their name out there. And it sort of backfired because, one, it's a terrible take, obviously, considering Turtle Rock has made both of these games. And from what I've heard about Back 4 Blood and from what I've played in the beta, it definitely isn't just a cheap copy. It is a lot of fun. But Turtle Rock decided to come back at them saying, 11 herbs and spices and still no taste, referring to KFC chicken. That's pretty funny because I kind of agree with the Turtle Rock Studios tweet that 11 herbs and spices and still no taste, as KFC definitely is not my favorite fast food fried chicken place, more of a Popeyes guy. And it's just interesting, I don't know why they would tweet that out just for fun. I guess they're kind of like the meme or parody console and they're taking on that role going forward. And as we know, the KFC console has like that slot where you can actually keep your chicken hot. And so it does kind of look cool, but they're definitely taking on that role as the villain within the video game industry. Anyways, guys, that's it for me. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments below. What do you think about Xbox's performance in Japan? Are you excited to see Hellblade 2 at the Game Awards if it shows up, or what other games would you like to see? And what do you think about KFC Gaming's tweet? Which fried chicken is your favorite? If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new here, you like what you saw throughout this video, I'd really appreciate you hitting that subscribe button to help this channel grow and help grow this community so we can have great conversations in the comments below. Thank you again for watching. Thank you for your support, and I'll catch you in the next video.